The crab. Let us find out what happened to a crab. In this fairy tale, when heads were being distributed to different animals in a far, far away time, long before the birth of humans on this earth, animals lived together comfortably and peacefully. In those days, no other animal except the elephant had a head of its own. The elephant was known to be the king of the animals. He had a collection of heads of all shapes and sizes, and he kept them in a huge cave. If any animal wanted to leave the village and go to the field or bush for some work, he would first go to the elephant and ask for a head. Once the animal came back, he made sure that the head was safely returned to the elephant. This continued for a long time, but all the animals were facing a problem. There was always shortage of one head. If by chance all the animals had to go out somewhere together, they could not go because one of them had to stay back. Some animals found this practice of borrowing a head every time very irritating. The king of animals, the elephant, also agreed that it caused a lot of inconvenience. He decided to have a meeting and find a solution to this problem. It was mutually decided that all animals would get a head of their own, and they would keep it with them and use it whenever required. The crab was the king's secretary. He assisted him in making the necessary arrangements. A crow was given a head. He had to go out to give notice to all the animals that they should all come to the village square and collect their heads from the king. The crow went round the village making announcements about the heads, and everybody who heard the news ran towards the village square to meet the king and get their head. After informing everyone, the crow started moving back to the village square when he saw the crab without his head going towards the river bank. The crow said to him,
"Listen, my dear friend, you must move back to the village square quickly."
The crab nodded and said,
"I am the secretary of the king, and I am sure the king will keep a head for me. So I don't need to rush. I am very tired, so I am thinking of taking a quick shower. I will meet you there at the square."
All the animals were waiting in a queue at the village square to receive their heads from the king. The king made sure that each animal got a head according to his own size. All the animals were very excited. The hippopotamus got a very large, fat head. The rhinoceros got a head with scary-looking horns. The giraffe got a long head that supported his long neck. The hyena was not liked by other animals, and it got the most unpleasant head available there. The most graceful of all the animals, the antelope, got the most beautiful head. After all the heads were given away, the king thanked the crow for his hard work and moved back towards his palace. On his way back, he saw the crab coming towards him.
"Where were you all this time?"
asked the king.
"I am afraid all the heads have been distributed, and there is not a single one left for you now."
The crab was shocked to hear that there was no head left for him. He requested the king
again and again, but the king was helpless. That is the reason why to this day the crab is without a head.